हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट एंट्रिक पैथोजन विच इज विब्रियो। नाउ विब्रियो एरोमोनास एंड प्लेसियोमोनास जेनेरा वर ओरिजिनली क्लासिफाइड टुगेदर इन द फैमिली विब्रियोनेसी बाय वेरॉन इन 1965 बिकॉज ऑफ देयर सिमिलर फिजियोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। Okay, they are primarily found in water, both seawater and freshwater, and their ability to produce disease was seen. However, genetic analysis established that they are only distantly related and belong to three separate families: Vibrionaceae, Eromenidaceae, and Plesiomonidaceae. Okay, the vibrios are differentiated from the related genera and families by certain features. Features like clinical disease, gastroenteritis, wound infection, sepsis, ear infection. So now, for gastroenteritis, for example, Vibrio cholera or Vibrio mimicus, they are involved. Okay, for wound infection, for example, Vibrio vulnificus, Vibrio damsella, they are involved. For sepsis, we have Vibrio cholera non-01 factor. We have Vibrio vulnificus. So every disease type, they have different species which are involved from Vibrio. Okay, genus Vibrio contains 35 or more distinct species of comma-shaped bacilli, but only 12 species have been implicated in human infections. Okay, now let's see, as our objectives are classification and biochemical character, antigenic structure, viability characteristic of Vibrio. Let's see, Vibrio is a genus of gram-negative bacteria possessing a curved rod, comma shape, several species of which can cause foodborne infection, usually associated with eating undercooked seafood, okay? Typically found in salt water, Vibrio species are facultative anaerobes that test positive for oxidase and do not form spores. Vibrio bacteria live in coastal waters. As I told you, around 12 species of Vibrio can cause gastrointestinal illness in humans or other infections also. The illness produced by Vibrio bacteria is known as vibriosis. In most cases, the illness results from eating contaminated food such as raw and uncooked shellfish from water that contains the bacteria. Or exposing a wound to a contaminated water can cause a Vibrio infection of the skin. Fine. This is the microscopic image of Vibrio. Moving ahead, we will see biochemical reactions. Here, there are three groups: Vibrio cholerae, Vibrio parahemolyticus, Vibrio vulnificus. Their biochemical reactions are given over here. Here, one thing, when you see V written, see here, Vibrio vulnificus, in the line lactose, it is given V, it is variable. Okay, variable means either it can be positive, it can be negative, it can react with, or like you can say, it can be lactose positive also, it can be lactose negative also. Okay, it is variable. go through this biochemical chart. Next, antigenic structure and properties. Many vibrios show a single heat labile flagellar H antigen, antibodies to H antigen, not protective in susceptible host. The somatic polysaccharide O antigen used to subdivide vibrio species into serogroups is of fundamental importance in the identification of this organism. Vibrio cholerae 01 or 0139, they are the strain numbers, okay? Bengal strain are the causative agents of cholera epidemics. Most of the other serotypes are harmless. And antigenic variation plays an important role in epidemiology and virulence of cholera. Okay? I'll provide you with the notes. Go through it. If you have any doubts, do ask me. Thank you.